Hello, followers! Welcome to this video. Let's get a general and complete overview on the latest iMovie 2019 in a short time. Don't forget to leave us feedback and tips to improve our guides and subscribe to our channel for free and complete video tutorials in the future. Apple iMovie is a great video editing product with advanced features to create your own videos, such as media editing, transitions, special effects, and title templates. This is the right choice to realize simple and professional videos, slideshows, intros, and also trailers. When opening iMovie, its startup page opens, divided in three sections listed on top: Media, Projects, and Theater. The Media section is used to manage and check all your media clips imported inside iMovie, organizing these into collections called Events. If you right-click on the left side and go to New Event, you will create a new collection listed under iMovie Library. At this point, you can add videos, images, and audio files inside iMovie by using the Import Media button or dragging and dropping these directly. To remove the event, just right-click on it and go to Delete Event. To check any media file, just select it and use the big preview on the right. You can also hover over each file to check its content directly on its thumbnail. Inside the Projects section, you can retrieve all your iMovie projects saved and in progress. You can open any by double-clicking on it. Whereas the Theater section is a page connected to your iCloud account, in order to share your own videos and media across any other device online. To start from a new iMovie project, go to Create New under Projects. Here, you can choose between Movie and Trailer. Movies are custom videos made with your media files, edited and combined together as you like. Trailers are videos created from ready templates similar to film trailers, with fields and slots to fill with your media. In order to see how to use iMovie, let's start from a new movie. The new project opens on the main workspace, divided in several parts. On the left, you have all the main panels collecting media, samples, templates, and effects available. On the right, you have the video preview to check your video in progress, and at the bottom, the project timeline, where you edit and manage the content of your video. You can always come back to the startup page by using the Projects button in the top left corner. At this point, you can rename and save your new project that will be added in the Projects list with its name and thumbnail. If you hover over it, you can use the right button to manage, share, or delete the project made. At first, the new project is empty. So, you have to import any video, picture, or sound file to start working. You can add files by dragging and dropping these into the timeline from any Mac folder or from the panels on the left side. With My Media, you can pick files from your iMovie events. From Audio, you can import sound files from iTunes or GarageBand, and use sound effects to add audio effects. You can also browse and import media files by using the Import button. All the files imported inside the timeline are shown as colored blocks called clips, which are also collected under Project Media inside the My Media panel. There are two kinds of clips: Audio clips represent any audio or speech with a green background color and their sound waveform shown. Visual clips are videos and pictures with a blue color and progressive thumbnails showing their content. In particular, videos with audio also show their audio waveform on the bottom blue part of the clip. You can check these clips better by using the zoom bar in the top right corner. Use the video preview to check the project content in progress inside the timeline. Hover over the timeline content to check any frame and click on any point to fix the main gray marker. This is the starting point when you play back the content with the player or the spacebar key. To play back in full screen mode, just use its dedicated button in the bottom right corner. Inside iMovie, you can also record audio with your microphone by using the record button below the preview. As you click on it, the player changes, showing all the recording options in order to set input source, volume, or mute/unmute the project audio if you need. When you click on the record button, iMovie starts recording from the main marker after a 3-second countdown. Use the stop button to stop the registration and done to come back to the main player. Now, let's see how to work with a project timeline. All the clips are contained inside several rows called tracks, such as audio tracks for sound and recordings, and video tracks for videos and pictures. You can move these clips through time or different tracks by clicking and dragging these. Audio tracks are unlimited and are all placed below the video tracks, except the main audio track, which is always visible and placed at the bottom separately. Video tracks are indeed limited to two, divided in main video track and top video track. The main video track is the place where you collect the main visual content of the project. This does not admit any empty gap in time, so clips are changed in order if you move these. The top video track collects all the visual clips that must be placed above the main content and overlap in time. In this kind of track, you can move the clips freely, allowing gaps. The visual clips inside the top video track and the audio clips below the video tracks also get attached to each clip inside the main video track. You can see this through the blue or green connection between the two clips. In this way, if you move the clip inside the main video track, all the other clips connected to it will be moved together with it. Video frames and audio are part of a unique video clip by default. If you want to move and edit these separately, just right-click on the clip and go to Detach Audio. To stretch or shorten clips in time, just click and drag their edges. Consider that you can't stretch over their original duration, and you cut part of their content if you reduce these. You can also change the clip duration by increasing or decreasing its speed rate without affecting its content. If you right-click on a clip and go to Show Speed Editor, you can drag the marker on the right side of the clip to change its rate. If you stretch it, the clip will be played slower, showing a turtle icon. If you shorten the clip, this will become faster, showing a hare icon. This feature is not available on pictures. To cut, copy, or paste a clip, use Command and X, C, and V. When you paste, the timeline marker is taken as reference. To undo any action made, Just use Command and Z. To cut just a part of a clip, hold down the R key and click and drag on the interested region to select it and then cut. To split a clip in multiple pieces, just place the timeline marker and then right-click and go to Split Clip. On audio clips and on the audio part of video clips, you can adjust volume by pulling up or down the envelope line on these. Just make sure not to meet any red waveform, or you risk distortion on the output sound. With iMovie, you can also apply amazing transitions in order to introduce or end any clip in a cool way. On audio clips and on clips inside the top video track, you can add transitions by moving their left and right markers. Audio transitions change the clip volume in time, whereas visual transitions affect its opacity level. To apply transitions on the clips placed on the main video track, you have to use the Transitions panel instead. Here, you can hover over any transition to check it on the preview first, and then apply it by dropping at the beginning or in the ending part of a clip or between two clips. Double-click on the transition to adjust its duration and change its effect by dropping another on it. Let's see how to apply adjustments and effects on clips. All the tools and features to correct and enhance clips are collected above the preview. These get enabled or disabled depending on the kind of clip you have selected from the timeline. When selecting audio clips or videos with audio, you can use Volume to adjust the clip volume, and Noise Reduction and Equalizer to remove noise from the clip or balance its spectrum, depending on the template you choose. Use Speed to adjust the speed rate or reverse the clip, either saving or not its pitch. When selecting visual clips, you can use Color Balance to correct whites and color by taking any frame or point as reference. Use Color Correction to adjust contrast, saturation, and temperature levels. Go to Cropping to crop the clip in different ways. Use Fit to use the original clip size. Use Crop to Fill to crop the clip according to the rectangle you size and move on the preview. And use Ken Burns to apply dynamic zooms by editing the two start and end rectangles you see. Consider that a nice zoom effect is applied on all pictures by default. In addition, you can use the Rotate buttons on the right to rotate the clip by 90 degrees. Remember to apply all by using the checkmark icon on the right. The clips placed on the top video track also show video overlay settings to adjust how these clips must behave when overlapping other clips. Cutaway is the default option, showing just the top clip with opacity level and fade transition defined. Select green-blue screen to merge the top clip and the clip behind it where the colors are either green or blue. Use split screen to show both the clips cut in between. Choose picture-in-picture to show the top clip reduced in size. You can click and drag it to move it and use its blue nodes to scale it as you need. You can also apply any border or shadow effect from the options above. Inside Clip Filter, you can add amazing visual and audio effects to your clips. On Clip Filter, choose the visual effect to apply, hovering over any to get a fast preview of it. Use Audio Effect to apply audio effects. Inside your project, you can also add pieces of text by using the Titles panel. Hover over any template to check it on the preview, and then drag and drop it above all visual clips to show text on these. You can also import titles inside the main video track, but in this case, the title gets a black, empty background. The title clips are shown with their text content and a violet background. You can move and edit these just like other clips and adjust the text font, size, color, distribution, and style under Title Settings. Use the preview to type text directly. iMovie saves your project in progress while working on it. Whereas, if you want to save and export your video outside iMovie, use the Share button in the top right corner. Here, you can either send your video to social websites with optimized setup, or choose File to fix rendering options on your own and save your video inside your Mac. In this case, add description, tags, and on format, choose whether to import everything or just audio. Fix the video size up to 1080p HD on resolution, and set quality and compress levels. Once you click on Next, you can set video file name and where to save it. The video will be rendered in background with a progressing circle in the top right corner. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel and our website for extra content, tips, and tutorials for Mac.